All right, hello class. Today we're going to dive into equilibrium, and we'll be able to write equilibrium expressions for balanced chemical equations, whether they are heterogeneous or homogeneous. We're going to evaluate our K for our reactions, whether it's KC, which is dealing with concentrations, or KP, dealing with pressures, both the reactants and the products, or by calculating it from the initial concentrations and the equilibrium concentration of at least one substance. The quest that goes with this is general and gas phase equilibrium number one. Okay, so with chemical equilibrium, we tend to think that when equilibrium is reached, that the reaction has come to completion. This is not actually true. With chemical equilibrium, the rate of the forward reaction is equal to the rate of the reverse reaction. So the reaction has not actually stopped. It's just come to a point where two competing reactions in the opposite directions are happening at the same rate, so it appears that there's no change in concentration. There's no net change of those things with respect to time. So to us, it appears that the reaction has stopped, but in reality, things are still flowing back and forth and shifting from one side to the other. This is referred to as a dynamic equilibrium. When we're looking at equilibrium constants, we're actually going to draw a pretty big connection to our kinetics rate laws that we just talked about. So with kinetics and rate laws, we can look at both the forward and the reverse reaction separately. So if we have this forward reaction, what would the rate law be for this reaction? Okay, if we're just looking stoichiometrically, we could say that the rate law is equal to Kf times the concentration of my N2O4, and this is first order. If I look, this agrees stoichiometrically, that's technically a 1 there, and we know that this is a 1 here. I can also do the same thing for my reverse reaction. Given the reverse reaction, what would my rate law be? Okay, the rate law of the reverse reaction would be NO2 squared. So we know at equilibrium that my concentration, or not my concentration, we know at equilibrium that my rate of the forward direction, so that would be this one, rate of F, is equal to the rate in the reverse direction. So since they are equal to each other, we could reasonably set these equal to each other. When we set those equal to each other, we get Kf equals N2O4 equal to Kr times NO2 squared. So if we want to rearrange these things, we could say Kf over Kr is equal to NO2 squared over N2O4. So if we look at it this way, if we look at the forward reaction here, we see that reactants are on the bottom and products are on the top, which is typically the convention that we will go with. So we can now take that and set that equal to our equilibrium constant, our K value. So since the equilibrium constant is the point at which the forward rate is equal to the reverse rate, we can set our rate constants equal to each other, and then that is equal to my Keq, all right? So the key here is products over reactants, and we're using our balanced equation. So in general, we don't necessarily always need to have our rate law to do this. If we have a balanced equation, we can set up our equilibrium expression in this format here, where we have the products over the reactants, and each of those are raised to the respective powers dictated by the coefficients. So concentration of C to the C power, concentration of D to the D power, etc., etc. Okay. So writing equilibrium expressions is actually fairly straightforward. We just have to remember products over reactants. A lot of this should be review at this point, because we actually have covered a good bit of this, especially in our a study of thermodynamics and electrochemistry. We've had a relationship to K that we've been exploring this entire time, so this should be hopefully straightforward for you. So we want to know, what are the equilibrium expressions for these reactions? Okay, so in the forward direction, let's see, we're going this way. I know it's products, so I can say my KEQ is equal to my products on the top, so the concentration of NH3 over my reactants, so I've got N2, H2 cubed, okay? And that would be my equilibrium expression. Now, it's important to notice that we have heterogeneous equilibria. That was in our objective, heterogeneous versus homogeneous. Now, when we say heterogeneous versus homogeneous, this refers to the phase. So if it's the same phase, it's homogeneous. We notice here that everything is a gas. Okay. If it is heterogeneous, you might have a reaction with some solids or liquids in there. We typically only put gases and aqueous concentrations in our equilibrium expression. Solids and pure liquids are usually left out. So I'll make a note of that. Okay. So go ahead and identify the equilibrium expression for my second reaction here. Okay. Products over reactants, you should have said SO3 squared over the concentration of O2 times SO2 squared. And this is equal to KEQ. Pretty straightforward. Okay. Write the equilibrium expression for the following reaction. Go ahead. Okay, and this looks complicated, but it's actually pretty straightforward. You just have to keep track of your exponents, and that's all. So same thing, KQ products, NO2 to the fourth power. Water is a pure substance, but because it's in the gaseous form, we're looking at the vapor, so we can include it here, which is good. H3 to the fourth, and O2 to the seventh. Perfect. Okay, so there are other times you may be given a description of the reaction, and you'll have to go through and balance the equation first, which is pretty easy. Once you balance your equation, then you can write your equilibrium expression. Just be aware of that. You may have to review some naming rules. So the decomposition of solid phosphorus pentachloride, we've got PCl5, and that's a solid, and it goes to liquid. So PCl3, and it's liquid, and Cl2 gas. Okay. Well, if we were to balance this, it's actually already balanced, which is nice. This is a cursive L. Sorry, I know that's a little sloppy. If we were to write the equilibrium expression for this, K is equal to my product, Cl2. And that's it. Why does nothing else belong in that equilibrium expression? Okay, you should have said the phases. Look at this, we got a solid and pure liquid. Solid and pure liquid have no business in your equilibrium expression. If you wanted to write Kp, you could talk about this in terms of pressures. Kp, we use the convention P of R our gas, so P of Cl2. If we had an exponent that we had to write, we would put parentheses around it, and then to the power. We only do parentheses with Kp. If we're talking about K, or in this case, Kc, we're just looking at concentrations and we use brackets. Okay, so let's try number two. Copper sulfate, pentahydrate. Okay, copper 2 sulfate, and that is with 5H2O, and this is a solid. And so we get our water vapor, H2O. So my 5H2O, and this is a gas, plus solid copper sulfate, solid. What would my equilibrium expression be here? It would just be H2O to the fifth. Because we have solids. Solids have no business in our equilibrium expression. All right. Now, the other side of this, if I wanted to do Kp, because we're talking about a gas, we can look at pressure. This would be the P of my H2O. And, oops, sorry, I broke my own rule. Here we go. Parentheses to the fifth. Okay. So the relationship between Kc and Kp is very important. If we look at the ideal gas law, we can use that relationship to help us figure out our molarity here. So concentration and pressure are related to each other. And I'm going to spare you the entire derivation and just give you the equation. We have Kp is equal to Kc times RT. And because we are now dealing with the regular ideal gas law, this is 0.0821. We're back to this version because we're in atmospheres, liters, moles, and Kelvin. Okay, so RT raised to delta N, which is the change in moles. And what I mean by that is in you have a balanced equation. It's the change in moles from one side of the reaction to the other. So products minus reactants. So total products minus total reactants. Okay. Cool. So here's one of my problems. I've got the formation of nitrosyl chloride. And it was studied at 25 degrees Celsius. The pressures at equilibrium were found to be 1.2 atmospheres, 5.0 times 10 to the negative second atmospheres, and 3.0 times 10 to the negative first atmospheres. They want me to calculate the value of Kp for this reaction at 25 degrees. Okay, well this is easy. They give us all of our pressures at equilibrium. So I just have to come up with my equilibrium expression. So I've got my products, so P nitrosyl chloride, and this is squared because of the balanced equation. And these are all gases, so these are all going in. I've got P of NO, and that's squared. And then I've got my pressure of chlorine, and that is just by itself. Once I have my expression set up, I can plug in all my numbers. So 1.2 atmospheres squared, and I've got 5.0 times 10 to the negative second atmosphere squared, and then I've got my 3.0 times 10 to the negative first atmospheres. Okay, so order of operations, I need to put this in my calculator. Do all your exponents first, then your multiplication, then divide. So I've got my 1.2 squared, and then I'm dividing that by, oops, too many parentheses in here. 1.2 squared divided by 5e to the negative second, and that's squared. make sure I put in enough parentheses here, and then times my 3e to the negative first. Okay. And let me double check my numbers, make sure I got that. Yep. Oh. Too many parentheses here. There you go. So 1920. If we look, there appears to be, so this is an equilibrium constant of 1920, which is large, which is good. We'll evaluate that in a second. 1920, there appears to be two sig figs in each of these. So this is really 1.9 times 10 to the third. And equilibrium constants do not have units, so we can leave it just as 1.9 times 10 to the third. Okay. Now, if I was to evaluate this, use your prior knowledge, a large K, does this mean that the reactants are favored or that the products are favored? Large K means that the products are favored at equilibrium. There's way more products, so keep that in mind. We'll review that in another play posit. Just try your best with it as we go. So we'll do one more. So using the value of Kp from before, calculate the value of K. So we have 1.9 times 10 to the third, and this is Kp. Well, now we can use that equation we had. We said Kp is equal to Kc times RT times the change in moles. Okay. Well, if I look at the change in moles, my products, I've got 2 moles on my product side, minus 3 moles in total from my reactant side. So delta N is equal to -1. Okay. And I can plug in my numbers. Now, remember, temperature has to be in Kelvin. So 25 degrees Celsius is 298K. And we're using 0.0821 as my R. So let's plug in. We've got 1.9 times 10 to the third is equal to Kc times 0.0821 times 298K to the negative first. So if I want to solve, I want to divide by 0.0821 times 298 to the negative first. So I'm going to do that in my calculator first. 0.0821 times 298. I'm going to raise that to the negative first power. And I'm going to do 1.9e to the third divided by that. Okay. And I get 46,485 for putting that in two sig figs, 4.6 times 10 to the fourth. Okay, Kc equals 4.6 times 10 to the fourth. Pretty easy. Okay, good. And that is it for today.